Music at Lander University. We are so very glad that you are here this afternoon for a special choral concert. If you would do us a favor and silence your cell phones and get ready for a wonderful afternoon to hear the performers in University Singers and Old Main Singers. But if you don't already know, you are here at a very special afternoon in which we will celebrate and honor Judy Neufeld, Professor of Education, as well as Chuck Neufeld, Professor of Music. And so at the end of the concert today, we'll have a special celebration of Judy and Chuck, and then we hope that all of you will join us in Johnston Commons on this floor just outside the auditorium for a nice reception. And we hope you'll be able to speak to Judy and Chuck. And a very special warm welcome to any friends and family of Judy and Chuck as we celebrate them and our students this afternoon. So again, welcome to the Josephine Abney Cultural Center Auditorium at Lander, and we look forward to hearing our students, not me.
say thanks for everybody that's here tonight. It's very special to me, but it's very special to all of us, too. And I'm not quite sure what Dr. McMillan said, because we were coming in backstage while he was giving announcements, but I want you to know this is about some great music and some really good musicians tonight. So just hang on to your seats. It's going to be really good. Our concert theme is Music for a Lifetime, and I took a little bit of time to go through 4 file cabinets and about 6 boxes of music that I've performed over the years, and chose this concert based on what have I done and what pieces have really worked well for choirs that I've conducted over time. And so that's sort of our theme to my journey, Music for a Lifetime. Thank you for turning off your cell phones. That's a huge thing. And I don't know if you realize, you've never been up here, if anyone ever turns their phone on when it's in the audience and we see that light, it is incredibly distracting. And when you're trying to do something as complicated as that last 8-part piece, it's really a mess sometimes. So please, keep those phones off. We appreciate that very much. And thank you for not talking or moving in the aisles while we're singing. So, you know, afterward, if there's applause and you need to move, go right ahead. But that's another distraction. So our next piece is Beati Quorum Via. I have students that have sung this piece before that come back to me over time, and then they say, could we just sing Beati one more time? It's such a great piece. And then Song for a Theme is just an incredibly emotional piece and lots of fun for us to sing as well. And finally, on this set, Randall Thompson's Hallelujah. It's a great, wonderful piece that is sung all over the world. In 2015, I went to Russia with a choir. They wanted to sing Randall Thompson's Hallelujah with us because we were the Americans and we could show them how to do it. It's such a great piece, it really is. And you know what? My mom and dad sang the Randall Thompson Hallelujah in their high school choir for a contest when they were in school. And so, you know, it's just got a rich history. So here we go.
Thank you.
Leighton Singers is getting themselves arranged for our next piece. Let me tell you a little bit about the Dravidian dithyramb, which was very famous, made famous, I should say, by an Indian, that's Asian Indian choir. And they were the kind of choir that back in the 50s, 40s and 50s, and into the 60s, toured around the world because they were just known for being amazing and incredible. And the next piece after that is Sicchio Vorrei Morire, which is one of Claudio Monteverdi's most famous madrigals ever. It's like on the top 10 list of madrigals ever written. And it's a great little piece. And then following that, two love songs by Robert H. Young. Robert was a good friend of mine when I taught at Baylor for just 1 year, but we got to know each other, and he was a tremendous composer and an even more tremendous person. And then Randy Stroop's The Pasture will follow that. And finally, we'll end with another madrigal.
Signore morire, giù. Thank you.
SASWLB. They didn't like it. So instead, they call themselves the Barber Cats.
Slaughter. When it's over, what will we get it good? Bachelor days we then recall. honey and baby. Farewell, my own true love.
True love, my honey.
I'm gonna go away and leave you. Never see you any.
Never gonna see you any.
I'm gonna sail upon that ferry boat. Never to return again.
Return again.
Goodbye, my Coney Island. Goodbye, my Coney Island. Goodbye, my Coney Island.
Bye, my Coney Island.
Do you guys know the musical Chitty Chitty Bang Bang?
Oh, yeah.
This next piece is not from that.
Now here is my love song, not fancy or fine. Like a rose, oh, won't you be mine, be mine. Like a rose, I'm home again, rose, to get the sun back in my sky. Light a rose, I'll never again rose, without a thousand kisses shy. Ding, dong, ding. I can hear the chapel bell chime. Ding, dong, ding. At the least suggestion, I'll pop the question. Light a rose, I'm home again rose, without a sweetheart to my name. Light a rose, now everyone knows that I'm hoping you're the same. So here is my love song, not fancy or fine. Light a rose, oh, won't you be mine, be mine. Light a rose, oh, won't you be mine.
Well, I want to tell a story about being in Scandinavia and taking a ferry from Helsinki over to Sweden, and the ferry left about 7 at night, and we got out into the open waters somewhere around midnight, and about 2 o'clock in the morning, the sun started to go down. And it went down over the horizon. We were all out on the deck watching this. It was so cool. It went down, and then we had about 5 minutes of semi-darkness, and then it came right back up almost in the same place. And that was night, because it was in the middle of the summer. And it was just an amazing thing. Well, the people that live in and work up in the northern parts of Scandinavia, just, they appreciate nature in a way that I don't think we ever will here in Greenwood, not because we're not good at it, but because it's different up there. And so this next song, Off Tone, is about being by one of the most gorgeous lakes you've ever imagined. And far, far off in the distance, you hear a hunter's horn blowing. And it just gets prettier and prettier and prettier from there. Off tone.
Thank you.
This is Elizabeth Gordon. She's going to sing a solo at the beginning of I'm Going Up Yonder. But we have a few more to add here.
Going up yonder, going up yonder.
The rest of Old Main Singers are going to come out here just in 30 seconds, I'm pretty sure. And Ms. Blackwood will also be with them, and they're going to perform a wonderful, wonderfully fun piece called Feller from Fortune. And come on out, Old Main. All of these instructions were written on a piece of paper, and I'm sure you're all looking at me going, what is going on next? Here they come, yeah. I love working with college students. You just never know what's going to happen sometimes. And I got to tell you, this year, being post-COVID has given us freedom to sing. And we have laughed, we have giggled, we have made jokes, and we have sung our hearts out in rehearsals all year. It's just been wonderful. And all of both University Singers and Old Main have just been tremendous to work with. And I couldn't ask for a better group this year. They're just awesome. Feller from Fortune. It's a little bit different. Just no offense, but it comes from Canada.
Oh.
Hawkins used to say, a moment of personal privilege. I don't believe, dedicated a song to my lovely wife, Judy.
Aww.
Where is Judy? She just left. Systems. He tells me I'm going to get free healthcare insurance. And we know that next year he will be making more money than God. So. But we're going to miss him and a bunch of other seniors that I will name later. This is I'll be seeing you, and maybe Judy will see her when she.
Yeah.
to dedicate this next song just for you. Believe me, you're worth the wait.
Sound of
master's degree in Fort Worth, Texas. And this really young-looking kid, I was kind of a young-looking kid anyway myself, and anyway, he was also a master's, student in composition. I was there getting a master's in conducting and some things. He asked me to play for his graduate composition recital. And I said, sure, no problem. And it was this wonderful little cantata that he had written. And I was playing trombone at the time on it, playing trombone for it. And it was a lot of fun. Later on, I happened to see his name go by, and I thought, oh, that's that guy. He published something. Well, his name was Pepper Choplin, and he's now published like 300 pieces. And this one that we're about to do with the guys is called Walk a Mile.
Walk a mile, walk, walk.
I told you I was going to tell you about a few more seniors and folks that won't be back with us next year. First on the list is, and folks, wave your hands when I say your name, Will Godfrey. He'll be graduating in May and plans to work in the music field. Elizabeth Gordon will be graduating in May and has plans to start a business in the Greenwood, Abbeville County area. Anderson Lau will be graduating in May and plans to work in the music field. Theo Mutter will be graduating in May and plans to find a job in editing. Jessica Palmer will be graduating in May and plans to work in the music industry. Paul Ruzczyk may be returning to Poland at the end of the semester because that's his home. We're not sure if he's coming back, but we wanted to acknowledge him anyway. Audrey Shepherd may be moving north to attend the North Carolina School for the Arts in Winston-Salem. Enzo Stewart plans to join the United States Air Force right after school is out. So those are some folks that I'm going to miss a lot. Thank you all very much.
I'm gonna win.
Again, let me say thank you for sharing this afternoon with us. And I know that we would really appreciate it if you would join us in the art gallery after this concert. And we're about to do our last piece here. Dr. McMillan, is that okay with you? Oh, here we go. Okay. I knew there was something planned. Judy, this is for you.
So it's my pleasure to turn the microphone over to Sarah Hunt Barron, who is Dean of Landers College of Education.
And today it is truly an honor to recognize Dr. Judy Neufeld and celebrate her retirement. Everyone in this room who has had any interactions with Judy would describe her as compassionate, caring, and the consummate professional. For 22 years, 12 of those as dean, I don't know how she did that, honestly. She has served Landers students, faculty, and staff, leading with grace and generously sharing her wisdom with her colleagues. Just to give you a sense of the impact Judy has had on her field and our region, Dr. Neufeld has taught 30 unique courses while at Lander and conservatively impacted the lives of over 2,000 teachers. She herself is a stellar teacher. Students love her courses and universally praise Judy for her wide variety of teaching techniques and ability to help students master challenging materials and for those of you that know Judy well, it comes as no surprise that she has quietly supported, assisted, and collaborated with departments across campus for over two decades. Judy's willingness to help and serve others has extended far beyond our campus. Long before I set foot in Lander, Judy spent an entire Saturday with me on the phone, walking me through how to correct an accreditation report that my university had submitted. I think that encapsulates who Judy is. She is generous and kind, thoughtful, and always measured in her approach. It is these qualities that allow Dr. Judy Neufeld to pursue her job with an unparalleled level of professionalism, earning the respect of her colleagues and students. It has truly been an honor to work with Dr. Judy Neufeld. She will be missed next year as she embarks on her retirement.
Chuck came to Lander 14 years ago as Director of Choral Activities and Associate Professor of Music. He was, of course, promoted to Professor of Music and brought decades of experience to our campus. And as you have seen this afternoon, he has mentored and guided and counseled music and music education majors, but also countless students across all fields across the campus that come to our choirs. Chuck has worked with students individually and as groups, and he always insists on high standards, and sometimes making students learn lots of languages. He has mentored students who are now proud Lander alums who serve in their own right as choral directors and have won state awards. And our choirs have performed on this very stage for 70 years and helped to educate and to entertain our community. So in addition to shepherding students for success, he has shepherded our community for wonderful enrichment. In the community, serving both as artistic director and conductor of the Lawrence County Chorale, but also helping to lead music productions of the Greenwood Community Theater. As a performer, Chuck has performed in 43 states, 12 European countries, in venues such as Piccolo Spoleto, and at the Moscow State Conservatory, with the Augusta and Aiken Symphonies, with the Phoenix Symphony, Fort Worth Symphony, and even the Boston Pops. And I would encourage you to see more about Chuck's illustrious career in our program. Tonight, we also have at least one member of the Cecilia Ensemble in the audience, and that's a group that has performed all over our nation and in Russia. So we hope that in his retirement, that Chuck is somehow able to take that baton and instruct the Boston Red Sox for the World Series. But I don't know, it may take him a while to do that. But what we can say is, for 14 years of excellence, we are so very grateful to you, Chuck, for all you have done for Lane University.
Those of you that have been here so much and are friends of ours over the years, we're not disappearing from the community. We're going to be around, so hopefully we'll be seeing you. I think we're going to do another song, and it seems to me that Freddie Mercury has perhaps laid some groundwork for the future of choral music. And we would like to sing for you that old favorite that, so, you know, I wanted to have little, like, bicycle bells ringing about this time. Anyway, but this is Find Me Somebody to Love by Freddie Mercury. Yeah.